Hi everybody, and welcome back to That Girl's Yoga YouTube channel. I'm so happy to be with you all here today and really excited that I've had so many requests and DMs and text messages and phone calls to bring another asana practice, another physical yoga practice to my YouTube channel. Today we will get started with a blanket, two blocks and a strap, and take your moment here to find a comfortable seat onto your blanket in Sukhasana, easy cross-legged seated pose. You'll take that blanket and place it so that you have a seat onto it, and if you feel that your hips are feeling tender, you can take blocks and you can tuck them underneath the thighs. If you don't have blocks, have no fear, you can use maybe something that's lying around the house that looks similar and sturdy to blocks. Another way you can practice this posture is to take your blanket, and we'll open that blanket out one time if you have a Mexican blanket or any other blanket you have at home, so that it's about 3 feet in length. And you'll come onto the blanket with your knees and grab onto your block on its low level. We'll take the block and place it horizontally in between the ankles and come to have a seat onto the block for hero's pose. Now, if this feels uncomfortable for you, but you kind of like the way it feels, I'm gonna suggest you grab onto a second block or even a cushion from your sofa and have a seat there. And that'll help to elevate and lift your body so you can find some space in the spine. Now place me on pause and take a moment to go and find the support that you would like for your practice. And once you have found that comfortable seat, let your eyes close and just notice and observe how you are feeling physically today. Invite the muscles in the face to soften. And as I explain to you what we'll be focusing on class today, take this time to check in with your physical body, check in with your mental and emotional body, and invite those muscles where you might be feeling tension and tightness to soften. As you focus on your breath, inviting the breath to be slower, more mindful, breathing in and out of the nose. Now today we'll be focusing on a mudra called Pala Mudra. Pala Mudra is a really beautiful mudra that helps us to cultivate energy in the first and second chakra. Our first and second chakra are Muladhara, the first chakra. It is associated with the color red. And it is a really important chakra to find balance. As we move through our practice, we need to find that sense of being balanced and rooted. And our second chakra, Svadhisthana, that is the chakra that is in our solar plexus. It's below the solar plexus. And it's that area in our sacral region. And it is associated with our sexual organs, but it's not so much a sexual aspect. The aspect really that I'm focusing on today is just being aware that we all have these masculine and feminine energies and qualities within us. So it's just being aware that this is that area where life comes from, and how important that life is for us throughout every stage in our life. Now, there are some, there are three doshas that make up our personalities. Today I'll be talking about two of those doshas. All of us are tri-dosha, and what this mudra can help us with is to release anxiety. So that is the vata dosha. Vatas tend to get a little bit anxiety ridden when there are things that are happening that we don't have control over, and we can feel really anxious at times. And I know that that could be something that all of us experience from time to time. Another dosha is pitta. Pitta is that dosha where we can feel a little heated and maybe angry. And the frustration can turn into that anger of not knowing what to do when this anxiety comes up. And there were many wonderful qualities to both of these two doshas and all three doshas that I'm not going to take the time to explain today. I'll save that for another YouTube channel session. But I want to explain about these two today and how important it is that we find this connection to the root chakra and the second chakra so that we can release some of these angers and anxieties that come up with what's been going on in our world lately. To get started, let your eyes open and take your left hand and just your four fingers. So bring your thumb into your palm of your left hand and place your index finger so that it's just below your belly button. So you find that belly button and then you take the pinky finger and let the palm face up toward the sky. So the pinky finger is resting four fingers below the belly button of the left hand. And then we cup the left hand gently. And you'll take your right hand and bring that right thumb so that it's right at the belly button. And then cup the right fingers so that you can feel that energy between the fingers and the palms. Let your elbows rest softly by the sides and let your sternum stay lifted as you press into the buttocks. Close the eyes and direct the energy of your breath into this mudra. Mudras are special energy centers that direct the breath and the energy into certain areas of the body. Our fingers are highly sensitive charge areas and they have energetic magnetic fields. And when we place them to face one another, that can create a lot of energetic movement in certain areas. Now allow your breath to be directed at the base of the pelvis. When you inhale, feel where that pinky finger is and feel the breath rise from the pinky finger. Feel it rise up to the right thumb, rise up into the ribs and into the heart center. When you exhale, blow the air out of the lips and feel the body soften in that downward current of energy. Inhale once again, direct the breath into first and second chakra. Feel it move all the way up into the heart chakra and blow the air out of the lips so that the exhale is longer than the inhale to create that downward current of energy where the breath moves down and out of the body. Take several more rounds here, just noticing and observing the effects of this mudra. Now we hold within our hands the energy of life force. This is where our prana begins and where the prana releases out. So this is helping to stimulate our digestive organs and all of the eliminatory areas where we eliminate any waste that is no longer needed in our body. When we can cleanse this area, we can help to cleanse the thoughts and the mind and that tightness that might happen in our belly, our lungs, and in our chest and in our hearts. Take five more rounds of this breath and allow yourself to be really silent and still. Notice what might come up, what is present, and how you can sit with it. You finish with your fifth exhale, release your mudra by bringing the palms together for Anjali Mudra. Touch your thumbs into your sternum and gently bow your forehead forward. Hold on to this energy that we cultivated in our palms and sense that we are connected, rooted, and grounded into a safe space, into the earth from our root chakra to the second chakra, on all the way up to the seventh chakra. As we hold this energy that we cultivated in our palms, let this energy release into the heart center. And take a moment, based on any discoveries of what was present, to set an intention for your practice today. If no intentions come to mind, allow yourself to be the witness and the observer. If you'd like to practice with my intention today is to listen. To listen to what comes into the present moment. As we practice through this practice together, may we all be protected by this energy that's from within us. And as we share this energy from within our hearts to each other, let us feel that interconnection of the conscious collective. Let your eyes gently blink open and remove that block if you have a block that you're sitting upon. You're welcome to stay onto a blanket if that feels comfortable, or you can remove that blanket and come to sit onto your mat or to your blanket. Place your hands onto your kneecaps as you come into Sukhasana, easy cross-legged seated pose. Inhale to lift the chest and lift the gaze up for seated cow pose. Exhale, round through the spine for cat. Keep going, pace of the breath. The eyes can stay closed here if that feels comfortable. Notice as we gently warm the spine, that first and second chakra are very much a part of this movement. As you feel the base of the pelvis press into the earth beneath you, and as we pull and round through the spine, that belly pulls in, and you can feel that we're stimulating through second chakra. Feeling rooted and grounded into our practice helps us to feel rooted and grounded into our life, regardless if we're in charge or if we're in control of what's happening. Now come on up into a seated pose and lean to the left, fold forward for Sufi circles. Lean to the right, round through the spine, and keep going at the pace of your breath. And what we're doing here is we're building and bringing up the Kundalini energy. This Kundalini energy that resides at the base of our pelvis, and as we stimulate this energy, it moves. It moves through both the masculine and the feminine energies called Ida and Pingala, and they move very much like a serpent. They circle up to Shuddha Nadi, which is the inner channel of the spine, where the prana, the breath, moves up to the crown of the head. Now reverse the direction. Your circles can be small, they can be big, they can be slow, and they can be fast. I always advise starting off the circle slow, and then you can increase as you feel more and more comfortable with this movement in your body. Come on back to stillness. Inhale to lift the arms up toward the sky. Exhale to release the left hand down toward the mat. Bring the right arm up and over for a lateral bend. Inhale, lift both arms up. Exhale, lateral bend over to the right. Turn this into a flow. Inhale to lift the arms each time. Lean over to one side, keeping the buttocks firmly rooted for each lateral bend. Feel the gentle opening of the sides of the body, lengthening muscles around the SI joints. Come on back to center, lift both arms up toward the sky once more, and bring your hands in toward heart center. Bring your arms and your hands out in front of you, come into a seated forward fold. If this feels uncomfortable for your body, don't fold quite so deep. Keep your chin so that it's parallel to the mat. And let the gaze just gently drop down directly from the nose. buttocks and feel the hips broaden. Take a breath in through the nose and sigh the air out of the mouth. Walk your hands, your torso, and your head over to the outer left corner of your mat. Press into your right buttocks. Take a breath in. And as you exhale, walk back to center. Inhale to walk over toward the right hand side. Press left hip back toward left heel. Breathe. Don't be so concerned with releasing the forehead down. Back to center and bring yourself into a tabletop pose. If you need support underneath the knees, please place a blanket underneath your knees. Knees go underneath the hips, the palms go underneath the shoulders. We stack the joints here to create that proper support. Exhale to round, feel the spine, cat pose. Inhale, let the tailbone lift. First, feel the tilt of the pelvis. Cow pose. Exhale, round to cat. And continue at the pace of your breath. Today we'll be doing several different variations of vinyasa flow. Now, vinyasa flow isn't necessarily a whole bunch of chaturangas. If you want to do more chaturanga dandasana, you can always add that into your practice. It's always important to honor where you are in your practice. At the end of your exhale, press your hips back towards your heels for child's pose. Now bend your elbows and crawl your chest forward as if you're crawling underneath a barbed wire fence. This is our cow pose. Exhale, round for cat, and keep this as a dynamic movement. Inhale again to crawl the chest forward, cow pose. Exhale for cat, and take several more rounds, feeling the fluidity in the spine, and that warmth and that awareness that we created in first and second chakra. If you have an ujjayi breath, constrict the muscles in the back of the throat to make that thicker sounding breath on the inhale. And that same thicker nasally sounding breath on the exhale. One more round, inhale. Exhale, press back and hold extended child's pose. Extend, keep your sternum lifted, press your hips back toward the heels, release the forehead down. Elbows can stay lifted or elbows can be bent. Press the hips back and breathe space into the back body. Feel as if your back body were expanding like a balloon when you inhale. Low back, mid back, upper back expand, and when you exhale, feel that contraction and that release as the balloon deflates. Take three more rounds of breath here, feeling into all that space we're cultivating. Inhale, tabletop. Exhale, extend right leg out behind you. Let the leg stay lifted at hip height. Round to the spine for half sunbird pose. Inhale, lengthen as we continue with dynamic half sunbird. If you're feeling that you want to add a little more heat into your practice, take your left arm and extend it out in front of you. Bring left elbow toward the right knee. Extend out through the crown of the head. Find length and energy from the tip of the toes all the way to the tip of the crown of the head or the fingers if you're using left arm. Take one more round. Inhale, full sunbird or half sunbird. Now, if you're in a full sunbird, take your left arm, open it out to the side. If you're in a half sunbird, you'll just bend your right knee. For those of you that were that took your left arm out, point that thumb down, grab onto your right ankle or foot, and kick the foot into the hand for tiger pose. Breathe. Inhale once again, your version of sunbird. Exhale, press back, extended child's pose. Inhale back to tabletop pose. Take your right leg and extend it out behind you once more and slide the right foot outside the outer left corner of your mat. You can stay to the ball of the right foot, or you can take the top of that foot flat. You can press into the foot, lean forward, press back. Gaze can look over the left shoulder as you breathe awareness into the right IT band. Those deep rotator and extensor muscles. Bring it on back to center and lower the right knee down. Meet me standing onto the knees. Bring your arms out in front of you and roll out the wrists. Reverse the direction. Now, if your wrists are getting tender and getting sore here in these postures, you can always turn your fingers out. So you'll see how my thumbs are going to point forward and my fingers are out, and that takes some of the pressure out of the front of the wrists. You can also make fists and rest onto the knuckles. Back to your tabletop pose. Take left leg and extend it out behind you for half sunbird pose. Square the hips to point down toward the mat. Feel that the crown of the head is lengthening out in front of you. Round through the spine, half sunbird, dynamic flow. Inhale to lengthen. You know your practice. If you want to go deeper, extend out through the right arm. Knee into the chest or elbow toward the knee. Inhale to your version of sunbird. If you're going with full, take right arm out to the side, turn the thumb down, grab onto the left foot or the ankle, kick the foot into the hand, find your version of tiger. If you're still in a half sunbird, pull the belly into the spine and lift just the left leg for your version of tiger. Take a breath in. Exhale, find space, notice what is present. Inhale, either full sunbird or half sunbird. Lower the hand down if you're in a full sunbird. Lower the left toes down. Slide left leg to the outer right corner of the mat for an IT band stretch and turn your head to look over the left shoulder. Now you can stay stationary here or rock forward. And really notice your wrists. Give them that attention that they need. Lift the left leg up, bring the head back, lower the knee down, and meet me once again on your hands and your knees for tabletop pose. Now take your hands and turn your fingers towards each other. And just lean a little bit to the left and lean a little bit to the right. And then turn the wrists so the insides of the wrists face each other. Maybe lean forward, lean a little bit back. Just kind of explore, maybe circles here with the hips. And then come on back up, lift the arms up toward the sky, interlace your fingers over the head, flip the palms up toward the sky and try to touch the thumb tips and the pinky tips together. Lengthen through the arms, roll, open the arms out wide and roll out your wrists. Reverse the direction. Transition into down dog. Press your hips up toward the sky to find your down dog. and pedal out through the feet. Bend and straighten through one knee at a time. Let your hips gently rock side to side. Today we'll be focusing on standing tree pose. Now, tree pose can be a little more challenging if you are on carpeting. So you might see me fall out of it, and that's perfectly okay. We'll work a little bit here to prepare the body for our peak pose today. Really be focused and aware on noticing what is present and what comes up and how we can sit with it. Next inhale, place the gaze toward the top of the mat. Exhale, step, hop, or flip, top of the mat. Uttanasana, forward fold. Inhale, bring hands to the shins for these first few rounds of forward fold. If you're modifying, hands can come to the thighs or you can have your blocks out in front of you. Exhale, back to Uttanasana. Inhale, Ardha Uttanasana, flat back. Extend the crown out, extend the tailbone out. Exhale to fold. One last round, inhale. Find this space and stay here. Now take a look at your feet. Notice your feet and can you spread your toes out wide? Feel the four corners in contact with the mat and that slight little lift to the arch of the feet. Can you feel the outer edges of the feet press into the mat and that extension from the tailbone all the way to the crown of the head? Lift your arms up toward the sky, maybe a gentle bend into the knees, Urdhva Hastasana. Exhale to release and bring hands in toward heart center for Tadasana. Now look at your feet and really be aware of how you stand. It's super important how we find our foundation in our practice. A lot of us, our toes kind of go out to the sides and that can affect a little bit about the way we work in this practice. So we want to make sure that our feet are always facing, the toes are always facing forward. And really honor where you are. Don't think so much about bringing those feet directly together. For some people, that's really challenging. And if it's better for you to have your feet hips width distance, offer yourself that awareness. All right, Surya Namaskara A. Take an inhale, lift the arms up toward the sky. Exhale, forward fold, hands lead through heart center, hinge at the hips. Place a bend into the knees if you need the bend. Crown of the head releases down to the earth. Inhale, flat back. Exhale to fold, step back to high plank pose. For those of you modifying, lower down to the knees for knee down plank. Those of you in high plank pose, notice and observe, find your foundation in your toes. Let your heels lift up nice and high. Shift your shoulders so they're over your wrists. Lower down to the knees for this first version. Lower all the way down to the chest, the chin, and the belly for prone pose. Keep your elbows bent with your palms underneath your shoulders. Drop the forehead down to the mat. Inhale, low cobra. Slightly lift head, chest, and shoulders. Exhale, down to release. Inhale, lift up, low cobra. And exhale down to release. Inhale, one more round, lift yourself up for low cobra. Lower down. Inhale for tabletop pose. Exhale for high plank pose. Press into the toes. Let your hips lift as high as your shoulders. Tailbone is long. The belly, the abdominal muscles, they already know exactly what to do. We need to keep that tailbone long and then press back for down dog or press back extended child's pose. Bend into the knees, place the gaze toward the top of the mat, step, hop, or flip, top of the mat. Inhale, Ardha Uttanasana, flat back. Exhale, fold. Neutral spine, lift the arms up toward the sky, Urdhva Hastasana. Exhale to release and bring hands in toward heart center. We're gonna practice Surya Namaskara A, that's a sun salutation A. Two more times. Honor where you are. If you like chaturangas, then do a chaturanga. That's the push-up where we lower halfway and then we lift up into up dog. If chaturangas are challenging for you, this is your practice. Please honor where you are. There are days where I don't practice a chaturanga, even though I've been practicing yoga for such a long time. There are days where I just don't want to do that type of a back bend, and it's okay to honor where we are. Inhale, lift arms up toward the sky. Exhale, hands through heart center, hinge forward, Uttanasana, forward fold. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold, step back. Either lower down to your knees for knee down plank or choose a high plank. Shift forward, lower all the way to the belly for prone or halfway if your body's ready for Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhale, up, low cobra or up dog. Exhale, press back, either tabletop or down dog or child's pose. Bend into the knees, gaze forward, step, hop, or float, top of the mat on the inhale. Exhale, inhale, Ardha Uttanasana, flat back. Exhale to release, inhale, arms raise. Exhale, release and bring hands in toward heart center. Last round, inhale, arms lift. Exhale, forward fold, Uttanasana. Inhale, Ardha Uttanasana, flat back. Exhale, step back, make your choice. Either Chaturanga Dandasana or all the way down to the belly, low cobra or up dog. Exhale, press back, tabletop, child's pose, down dog. Take a breath in and sigh the air out of the mouth. Next inhale, gaze goes forward, bend into the knees, step, hop, or float, top of the mat. Inhale, Ardha Uttanasana, flat back, and exhale, fold. Inhale, arms lift up, Urdhva Hastasana, upward salute. Exhale to release and bring hands in toward heart center. Inhale, lift the arms up toward the sky, interlace the fingers to come into a steeple grip. Those fingers will point up toward the sky. We lengthen on the inhale, exhale, standing Ardha Chandrasana. Gentle lateral bend. Inhale, come back to center. Switch out the interlace on your steeple grip. Lengthen, exhale on over to the side. Inhale to lift up. Exhale to swan dive, forward fold, neutral spine. Don't forget the bend into the knees. Inhale to flat back. Exhale, down fold. Step yourself back for down dog. Lift your right leg up toward the sky. And bring that right knee in to your chest. And step your right foot forward to come into runner's lunge. Lower down the left knee. Walk the hands onto the right thigh. Lift the arms up toward the sky. Anjaneyasana. Deep breath in. Exhale, sink a little deeper into that front hip. Keep your tailbone long to protect the low back. Take a nice breath in. As you exhale, bring your hands in toward heart center. Lean forward and turn to the right for a twist. You can hook left elbow outside of right thigh. Bring the thumbs into the chest. If you're practicing a more advanced variation. If you're being more gentle, you'll keep your chest lifted for your twist. If anybody's looking for an extra challenge, you'll curl the left toes, lift the left knee up, and come into your standing variation twist. Lower the left knee down if you lifted it. Come back to center, lift the arms up toward the sky, Anjaneyasana. Lower hands down to the mat. Curl back toe, lift back knee up. Step front foot back to meet the back foot and flow through your vinyasa. Next inhale, left leg raises up toward the sky, hips nice and square. Bring the knee into the chest as you shift forward, step the left foot forward for runner's lunge. So runner's lunge is our medium lunge. Lower the right knee down. Transition into Anjaneya Asana. Lift the arms up toward the sky. Take a breath in. Exhale, bring hands into heart center. Lean forward and find your version of a twist. Maybe you want to challenge yourself and curl the back toe, lift the back knee up. Come into the runner's lunge twist. Squeeze outer hips in together. Feel the legs scissor toward one another. Chest is lifted nice and tall. Lower the knee down, come back to center. Lift the arms up toward the sky, Anjaneya Asana. Lower hands down, step back. Choose your vinyasa. So make sure it is something that is honoring your practice. Next inhale, we lift right leg up. Once again, bring it into the chest, lean forward. Notice all the muscles that are working here and how we're using those hip flexors to step the right foot forward to prepare for warrior two pose. This is one of the reasons I have a double mat here so that you can see me in these postures when I need to be sideways for my filming. Take your arms, open them out wide. Nice deep bend into the front knee, heel to arch alignment. Take a moment to find your foundation here in the pose. Let your chest stay lifted, arms open out wide. Gently squeeze the fingers together as you press into the outer edge of the back heel. Dynamic warrior two, straighten front leg, lift the arms up toward the sky, palms come together. Exhale back into your two. Inhale to lengthen. Exhale back to your two. Inhale, lengthen, find space in the body. Exhale back to two and hold. Notice what is present, what might be coming up. Can you relax the muscles in the face, across the chest and the shoulders? Feel the muscles in the inner thighs squeeze towards one another. This is helping us to increase bone density. Straighten front leg, bring the arms up, bring the hands into heart center, and turn that front foot to face forward so that your feet are parallel to each other. And you're about 3.5 to 4 feet apart. You might need to make an adjustment like I just did. Bring the hands to the hips. Squeeze the elbows together. Let the chest lift. Let the gaze lift. Prasarita Padottanasana, wide-legged forward fold. Hinge forward. Lower the crown of the head down. Hands can stay to the hips or the hands can come down toward the ankles. Now, if anybody has a practice of headstand, this is a really, really great opportunity to come into a handstand from tripod. Now, I'm not going to cue it. If it's something that you have in your practice, you feel safe and you feel comfortable doing that, offer yourself that awareness. Now, for those of you that have been wanting to learn headstand, there's a few different ways of going about this, and I am going to do a YouTube video on beginners headstand using the wall. But one of the things that has to happen first is we need to get the crown of our head down to the mat. Not every day, that's something that can happen. I know for me, yesterday I got it, and today I'm not there, and that's okay. For those of you in headstand, make your way back down. Everybody take an inhale to a flat back. And exhale, down fold. Bring your hands to your hips. Let your sternum lift you up. Bend into the front knee. Find once again, warrior two. reverse your warrior. Cartwheel your hands down toward the mat. Take front foot, step it back to meet the back foot. And flow through your vinyasa. Remember, you can always skip vinyasa. Never a have to. Ever, ever, ever. Next inhale, left leg lifts up toward the sky. We step that left foot forward as you bring the knee into the chest. Warrior two. Find your awareness here in the pose. Notice what is present, what is coming up, and how can you see this challenge as a way to let go of any anxieties, to let go of any feelings of inadequacy or thinking that you need to nail something or be a certain way. Straighten through the front leg, lift the arms up, dynamic warrior two. Beautiful. Stay here, hold, and observe. Reverse your warrior. Cartwheel your hands down to the mat, come to the ball of the back foot. You choose one more vinyasa or skip it. This is your time to do what feels most beneficial for your body. Take a breath in through the nose. Exhale, sigh the air out. Press back, extended child's. Inhale for tabletop, exhale, down dog. Place your gaze toward the top of the mat, step, hop, or float, top of the mat. Inhale, Ardha Uttanasana, flat back. Exhale, down fold. Neutral spine, lift arms up toward the sky. Exhale to release and bring hands in toward heart center. Now take your right knee and let your right knee march. As the right knee marches up, bring your hands onto your hip. It helps you to keep your balance. Cross right ankle over the left thigh for standing figure four pose. Bring your arms out in front of you. This is for the extra challenge. If you're happy with where you are, keep your hands on your hips or in at heart center. For those of you that want to create some eagle wrap arms, left arm wraps under right, we bend the elbows. Either box the hands together for eagle wrap or palms come together. Now we bend into the standing knee and sink the hips back and down. Keep your right knee pressing toward the outer right corner of the rim. Keep your sternum lifted. Breathe. Nicely done. Unwind the arms, lift the arms up, march the knee, stick the leg out in front of you, flex out through the heel, doesn't matter how high up you come up, bring the hands into heart center, and lower that foot down. Step right foot forward for warrior one. Press into the outer edge of the left heel as you bend into the right knee, lift the arms up toward the sky. Nice big breath in here. As you exhale, bring the hands in toward heart center. Warrior three, come to the ball of the back foot. Lift off with that leg, extend the leg out behind you. Keep your thumbs into your chest. And really think about the extension you're creating in this right leg. As you feel that extension, feel the same extension from the crown of the head all the way to the right heel. Come on up, bend the right knee, bring it into the chest, let it lift up as you march, and lower the right foot down, the left foot down. Now, we'll bring the right heel into the inside of the left ankle to get started with Vrikshasana tree pose. As we bring this heel into the ankle, pay really close attention to the left hip. If your left hip has scooted out to the side, that's gonna put too much pressure here in all these muscles of the left side body. So we wanna squeeze that left hip in. You wanna feel that your left foot, the four corners, are firmly rooted onto the mat or whatever surface you're standing upon. I always like to start off with this variation first in tree pose to give you an idea of what is working for you. Bring the hands into heart center, let your chest stay lifted, rest the ribs down toward the hips so that we feel that everything that we are in control of is all brought in here. We're feeling rooted from first and second chakra. Breath is moving freely through Sushumna Nadi. Now, if you want to go a little deeper, walk that heel and the foot to the inside of the left calf. Now, as you walk that foot in there, maybe this is easy for you and you're ready to lift your arms. Maybe this is where you stay, focusing on lifting the chest, or you want to go a little deeper. Take your right hand, grab into your right ankle, and press the right heel to the inside of the left groin there. Right there at the inside of the thigh. I hear a lot that my pants are slippery. Yeah, I agree, the pants are slippery, but it has to do with the muscles of the quads. So we use those quad muscles. You find your balance. We fan the right knee out to the side because we've created that opening in the pelvis today so that we can get that space in the right hip as the hip opens. Let your arms lift up toward the sky. Knit the ribs down. Feel the chest lifted. Stay here and breathe. You want to take it one more step further. Why are we doing tree pose? Because I had a request. So we'll take it one more step further. Bring your hands into heart. If you want to come into standing half lotus, maybe you take your hand and bring your right foot to the top of the left thigh so that that right knee points down. And we can try to bring that knee in line with the left knee. Now, for some of us, we have to hold on to the foot. Some of us can let it go. Maybe hands come into heart. Maybe arms lift. So find your variation. So I know that my leg is slipping down, and I'm going to hold on to my foot with my left arm. I'll take my right arm and lift it up. One more breath. And then let it go. Shake it out. Good news, second side. Left foot steps forward, warrior one. Bring your right foot back, find your alignment, either heel to arch, or that left foot can go out a little wider. This is all levels flow. You get to honor where you are. Put the arms up toward the sky. Bend into that front knee, find that space. Warrior three prep. Bring the hands into heart center. We kick off of the back foot so that the right heel is lifting or pressing into the right toes. We bend into the left knee and hinge at the hips as you extend the right leg out behind you for warrior three. Very much like our sunbird, we want to try to keep our hips nice and square. Long line of energy from the crown of the head all the way to the toes. Remember, carpeting is challenging. Come on up. Bring your right knee into your chest. Lift your arms up. Extend that right leg out. And then bring the hands into heart center and lower the right foot down. All right, Vrikshasana tree pose. Hands to the hips, bend into the left knee. Pivot on the left toes and let the knee open out so that the pelvis opens and we find extension in this left hip. Hands come to heart as you squeeze outer hips in together and you feel lengthened all the way from the four corners of the right foot to the crown of the head. Maybe you stay here and lift your arms. Maybe this is your practice today. Or you might want to try what it feels like to bring the sole and the heel of the left foot into the right calf. Give yourself some time to explore and notice what is present. How can you keep that awareness? Both the masculine and feminine energies moving through the body, through our prana. And then we'll try to bring the heel to the inside of the right groin. So if your pants are slippery, what do? We press the right thigh into the left heel. We press the left heel into the right thigh. You'll notice what that does is that squeezes the outer hips in together. That gives us balance. Hands in at heart, or the arms can lift. Keep thinking, left knee fanning away from the hip. Finding space in the pelvis, helping those rotators to be healthy. You want to try your half standing lotus. We'll take the left foot, bring it on top of the right thigh. Now really be careful if your knees feel sensitive here. So I have an injury in this knee here. And I'm not going to force myself to do that on this side. I know I could do it, but I'm not going to do it because that's not going to be serving me in this present moment. So for me, this is going to be a better awareness to stay with my heel into my thigh. This is something that I've been practicing for a long time, and I've had to learn so much through my practice of not being upset with myself because I can't do what I'm so used to doing. Bring your hands into heart center, set that foot down, shake it out. Really nicely done, everybody. Take an inhale, lift the arms up toward the sky. Exhale, swan dive, take the arms out wide, hinge at the hips, forward fold. Inhale, flat back, and exhale, fold. Lift the arms up toward the sky once more, and bring the hands in toward heart center. Now we bend into our left knee, bring the hands to the hips, let the knee lift and cross the ankle over the right thigh for figure four. Now you can place a little bend into the right knee and hands can come into the heart. And this is a really nice gentle variation. Another way of practicing this is just to place your foot onto a block. So I'll show you what that looks like. So this is another way of practicing this pose. And you can think that the knee is opening out to the side. Now, for those of you that are ready to invite your eagle wrap, you'll bring your arms out in front of you. Like I'm losing my balance here. And you'll take your right arm across it underneath the left. Bring the elbows up. Maybe you grab onto opposite shoulders or you wrap the arms around for eagle wrap. Sink into the hips, maybe a deeper bend into the standing knee, let the sternum stay lifted. Notice and observe, if you fall out, that's okay, because I'm falling out. One more breath in, one more breath out. Let it go, lift the arms up toward the sky. Exhale, forward fold, hands through heart center. Inhale to flat back. Exhale to fold, step back, down dog. Take a breath in. Sigh the air out as you lower the knees down, press back, extended child's pose. And let your body soften. Use your hands to press yourself up. And come to seated, facing the front of your room. Bring the soles of the feet together. And I'm going to show you something. So for a lot of us, when we bring our soles of the feet together, there's still a lot of space, and we might want to go a little deeper. So we don't want to force the heels closer in, because that can put too much pressure on the knees and on the groins. One of the best ways to do this is to bring your fingers behind you, and we're going to scoot our hips and scoot our pelvis closer to our feet. That creates less pressure on these really important muscles that are around the knees, so that we're not practicing from the joints. So I'm going to scoot back a little so that you guys can see me. Now we'll take index finger and middle finger, wrap them around the big toe. Inhale to lengthen, exhale to hinge forward to fold in your Baddha Konasana. Press the buttocks down, feel that the chest is lifted. Feeling the practice slow, nice, soft, gentle music to end the class. Notice your ujjayi breath. Maybe it was there during your practice and you had that awareness. Maybe you weren't consciously aware of it. But now is the time to be consciously aware of the breath. As we slow the mind and slow the body, use your hands to press yourself up. Then bring your legs out in front of you. Have your knees bent. We'll have a little bit of fun here with our abdominal muscles. Bring your hands to the backs of the thighs. Navasana, boat pose. Now, there's a few different, obviously many different variations for boat pose. And today we're gonna take a really gentle variation of this posture. When the hands come behind the thighs, you're going to lean back so that you are balancing to that really bony part of our buttocks. And you want to feel that you balance on that bony part there, and that the tailbone is forward. The sternum is going to stay lifted, and we can bring the knees so that they are at a tabletop. You can keep the hands here, or the arms can go out in front of you and a little bit out to the sides. Keep the chest lifted. Maybe the hands stay here the entire time. Make sure you're not holding on to your breath. You're still breathing. Try to tap the right toe down, lift the leg up. Tap the left toe down, lift the leg up. Lower your feet down, lower down onto your back. Bring your knees into your chest. Take a little rock side to side, massage the back. Transition into wide knee circles. Big toes come together to touch, knees open out wide. Extend out in front. When they come together, bring them into the chest. Keep going with these wide knee circles. Feel all that we did in our hips today in our practice. Invite the hips to integrate and feel this release of synovial fluid releasing into the hip flexors. Reverse the direction. Feel the oxygen pumping into the blood, the lungs, into the brain. Gentle stimulation once again, first and second chakra. Transition into reclined pigeon pose. Cross right ankle over left thigh. Pull the legs into the chest. Take a breath in and sigh the air out of the mouth. Hands can be clasped behind the left thigh, with a strap or over the front of the left shin. What this is going to do is it's going to support the left hip as we open the right hip. feels nice, offer a little rock. Breathe and observe. Allow your muscles in your face to relax and soften. And invite yourself to be present. To be present in the space that we're creating in the right hip. All that transpired in the practice. So we settle in and lower the left foot down. Place your hands where you're strapped behind the back of the right thigh. Extend the right leg up toward the sky. Inhale to press the thigh and the leg away, but resist with the hands. Exhale to pull the straight leg into the chest. Breathe into the right hamstring. Inhale again to extend. Feel contraction. Exhale, pull the straight leg in. Remember not to go too far. Inhale again, extend. And exhale, pull it on in. Bring right knee into the chest. Extend out through the left leg. Bring your left hand to the outside of the right thigh and extend right arm out to the side. Separate knee down twist. As you release the right knee down, maybe it comes all the way down, maybe not quite all the way down. Come to the outer edge on the left hip to lower the knee down if that feels comfortable. Take a breath in and sigh the air out. Right knee comes into the chest to prepare for Ardha Apanasana. Exhale, forehead to the knee. Inhale, full body stretch. Exhale, sigh all the air out of the body. Second side. Bend right knee, cross left ankle over right thigh. Pull the legs into the chest, reclined pigeon pose. Hold on where it feels comfortable, offer a gentle rock. Your jaw, the muscles in the face, the collarbones, the shoulders. Remember, rocking isn't mandatory. It's actually something that I don't prefer in my personal practice. I cue it as a teacher because I know a lot of people really enjoy that feeling. Breath in, sigh the air out of the mouth, lower the right foot down, lengthen the left leg up toward the sky, clasp your hands behind the back of the left thigh, inhale, extend the leg, press it away, resist with the hand, exhale, pull the straight leg into the chest, inhale again, lengthen and extend, exhale, pull the leg in. One more time, lengthen it, send it out. Exhale to pull it in, breathe into that space of the hamstring. Bring left knee into the chest, extend right leg long, separate knee down twist. Left arm out to the side, right arm pulls the left leg across the body, head gently turns to the left. You want to go deeper, come to the outer edge of the right hip, lower the left knee down. Really honor where you are as you breathe into spatial awareness. Come back onto the spine, prepare for Ardha Apanasana. Left knee into the chest as you inhale. As you exhale, forehead to the knee. Inhale, lengthen out long, full body stretch. Exhale, rest the arms down by the sides and prepare for your Shavasana. You might want to have props behind the backs of the knees. So really honor what it is that your body is needing here. Find that space to soften, close the eyes, relax, settle in. Heels drop towards each other, the feet away from one another. Relax through all 10 toes and all 10 fingers. Soften muscles in the face. Let your tongue settle where it feels organically natural. Relax the eyes into their sockets. Let this be this time, especially for you, to receive all the benefits of your practice. Feel the integration as the breath and the heart rate soften. Shavasana. Become aware of your body. Become aware of your body in the space in which your physical body occupies. The temple in which houses our soul. The temple in which we live upon. Bring your hands in front of your first chakra and second chakra, very much where we had our Apollo Mudra, and rub the palms together. Create a little bit of heat, a little bit of friction, and place your left hand onto your left side of your pelvis and your right hand onto your right side. And feel into this awareness. Sense that you are always connected to life through this awareness of where life begins, at our first and second chakra, knowing that in all stages in life, how important these first and second chakras are. Now walk your hands up to your heart. Take a breath in. Exhale, let anything that is no longer serving of you go. Bring your knees into your chest and roll your body to your right hand side. As you roll to your fetal position, take your right arm and rest your head into the crook of the arm. Take left hand and place it over to the heart once more. Thank yourself for coming to your practice. Feel into the heart that regardless if you are in control of what is going on outside of you, that you can invite yourself to sit with what's present. And notice if this is a call to action, this anxiety that might come up, and if you can bring maybe some new changes into your life as we learn to live with this new normal. Use your hands to press yourself up. Come into a seated pose, facing the front of your room. Bring the hands into Anjali Mudra. Touch thumbs into the sternum. Let the chest lift up and gently bow the chin into the chest. As we hold the gratitude for our practice in our hands, let this gratitude forever be held within our hands. And as it releases into the heart center, let it be forever held within the heart center. Thank you all for inviting me into your home and for practicing with me today. Have a beautiful rest of your day. Namaste. And thank you for tuning in to my YouTube channel. Please ask your friends, your family, and your neighbors to like my videos. The more likes I get, the higher up I get boosted, and the more subscribers that I can get. So ask them to like, subscribe, watch, join, practice, and enjoy. I can't wait to see you all soon. There'll be a new yoga nidra coming up soon, as well as a meditation practice. Have a beautiful day. Mwah.